Genetics lab video demonstrating the PCR procedure for the cheek cell test that you'll perform in the human variation lab. So at this point, you're partly through the procedure. You've taken a cup filled with sterile saline out of the lab because we can't put anything in our mouth inside the lab, squished it around, and spit it back into the cup, and then pipetted that, a mill of the sample, into a fresh, sterile microcentrifuge tube, and here you have it in front of you. And so now we need to break these open and access them. And so what you're going to do is you're going to centrifuge these following the procedure in the lab manual, and then you're going to add them to Instagene. Once you add them to some pre-prepared Instagene tubes, which will come to you in a tube looking just like this, with about 200 microliters in the tube, it's going to tell you to vortex the sample to mix. And the way you use a vortexer is simply to take your sample and push down on the top of the vortexer. Very simple, and it mixes it very nicely. Just a few seconds is more than you need, unless there's a reason that you need to mix it very, very well. You can have it set up to spin as fast as possible, and then just quick little mix is all you need. Okay? And then it tells you to heat it up to 56 degrees for 5 minutes, and then come back and vortex it again, and then back to 56 degrees, and then vortex it again, and then to 100 degrees, and then to centrifuge it. And so when you are centrifuging, make sure you follow the actual procedure, not my demoing of the actual little steps. When you're using a centrifuge, here's how you set the settings. It tells you to spin the samples for 5 minutes at 5,000 times gravity. And so our centrifuges all pretty much look the same. They have two knobs. One controls the time, and one controls the speed. They also have a third little button for very short spins. If you just hold this button right here down, it'll spin for as long as you hold it down, and it'll stop spinning when you release the button. So if you only want to spin it for 5-10 seconds to pull, you know, when there's just a bunch of little liquid on the side of the tube, you can pull it down using that button. It's very useful. But right now, what we want is a 5 minute spin. It's already set at 5 minutes. You can change it there. And at 5,000 times gravity. And so these numbers are times 5,000. And RCF means gravity. We can switch this from RCF to RPM by pressing the button. It goes back and forth. You can see that's actually 7,300 RPM. Well, we want gravity for this instruction. When it's turned off, when it's not spinning, I should say, we can open the lid. So let's do a cooking show demo and say we have done this. Now, of course, we did this correctly and had to have our sample balanced. So your sample always needs to be exactly opposite from something that is its balance. So always set up correctly. So we have our sample here. Now here's the thing. The PCR, when we use Instagene, works very, very well. When something goes wrong, it almost always goes wrong because someone shakes the tube. So what I suggest you do when you're going to do PCR on a sample that's been treated with Instagene, because what Instagene is a bunch of very small beads that are pulling down the metals that are contaminating your sample. They're chelating the contaminants out of your sample. You don't want to shake it up. If you mix your sample around, all the beads are going to start floating around. We don't want that. So what you do is leave your sample in the centrifuge. Get a pipette, get your PCR tube, and get all ready to go. What we want to do here is we want to transfer exactly 23 microliters right from our sample, and we're going to move it very gently. And I don't know if you can see it, but you can just see that right here, down here are the beads, and up here is clear liquid. We don't want any of those beads. So we're going to move this very gently. Gently pop the top. And when we pull out our sample, we're only going to put the tip in the very top of the sample, because we don't want one of those beads. And if you do that, your PCR works beautifully. If you get one of those beads, you get to do your PCR again. These PCR tubes are very fragile, by the way. You have to be gentle with them. Add your sample right to the PCR solution. You can gently mix it up a little bit. When you are done, make sure you close the cap all the way. It's going to get very hot. You don't want it to evaporate out, but be careful you don't crush the tube. And you're done with it. That. You all have racks that look like this in your drawers. These are for PCR tubes. You all have racks that look like this in your drawers. These are for microcentrifuge tubes. You're going to take this right to the PCR machine. Make sure you label this PCR tube in some way with some sort of symbol. It's going to be very hard to write more than just a little symbol on here. So it's very important that you fill out the sign-up sheet in the same location. The PCR machine has a block that's this same shape. And so wherever you put your tube in the PCR machine, there'll be a grid on a piece of paper for you to sign up your name so that we know who it belongs to. All right? Those are the key points. You have the full instructions in your lab manual. You get a few pointers from your TA, but that is the most critical thing. Don't get an Instagene bead. If you don't do that, your PCR will work.